on Fox 24 News.
Whew. It's, you know.
Yeah.
I forget what it's like waking up at 3 a.m.
It's weird. I know. You're hanging in there, Chase. You have a normal sleep schedule now, but today, filling in.
Yeah. Having a good time, having fun. Hopefully, Derek feels better. He's got strep throat. I hope, Derek, if you're watching, hopefully you feel better, buddy. But, you know, in the meantime, it's kind of a day. It's a Monday. It's kind of an active day. Temperatures kind of chilly, 65 degrees now for Odessa Midland, but cooler in places like Marfa at 54 degrees. Pecos now at 64 degrees. Now, we did reach down to 64 earlier here in Odessa Midland, but right now we've picked up a tiny, tiny bit now that the sun is up and beginning to warm us. Once we get to the afternoon, though, 89 degrees will be our high temperature. That's way above average for this time of year. So it's going to be kind of a hot day considering, but that heat is energy. Now think about an attic in your house, how it usually is hotter than the rest of your house. That's because that hot air rises up into the attic, and that is exactly what happens in the atmosphere. That hot air is going to continue to rise on up, and rising motion gives us rain chances. Now, not only do we have a lot of heat out there, we've got a lot of moisture too, we also have this wave of energy that's going to be coming in from the west. That'll kick off some thunderstorms a little bit later on this evening. We've also got a weak cold front that'll come through, dropping some of our temperatures down, but mainly we do have a chance for some strong weather in the northeastern basin. Looking at a lot of cloud cover right now, started to fill out a little bit across southeast New Mexico, but now filling right back on in. Same story south of I-10. Cloud cover breaking up for a little while and filling right back on in. Now, as we get to the afternoon time, we're going to see our temperatures really begin to pick up. It will be 89 degrees by this afternoon. It will be pretty warm and also pretty muggy, too. Notice 62-degree dew points here for Odessa Midland. A dew point measures how much moisture, how much water vapor is in the air close to the surface. An average for this time of year is low 40. So 62 is way above average for this time of year. Also notice we've got a little bit of a dry line beginning to set up. 15-degree dew points for Guadalupe Pass, way below average. So as that dry line pushes to the east, that could give us initiation for some of these thunderstorms. But either way, it indicates a lot of humidity out there, a lot of moisture, above average dew points, and a lot of warm afternoon temperatures coming through for us this afternoon and into this evening. That's going to give us enough energy to possibly give us some severe weather chances. Now, we can take a look at the satellite and radar model. That'll give us a good look. And this one, I think, is running pretty close to what I expect to be taking place later on today. We've got a couple of isolated thunderstorms developing around 4 p.m. this afternoon. But as we get to the evening hours, notice those thunderstorms really blooming, really blowing up. This is going to be a lot of isolated thunderstorms in the northeastern basin. The positioning, I think, is very, very close to what I expect. Odessa Midland could be in the path of some isolated thunderstorms as well. We may be talking about hail, maybe some damaging winds, and of course flooding. Anytime it rains here in West Texas is always in the cards. Now, as those storms track to the north and east, they do intensify a little bit. So places like Snyder, Abilene, I think have a good chance to see some very strong weather moving through this evening. By 10 p.m., most of that's dying down before we get to the overnight hours, and then it looks like those storms want to ramp back up again. So get ready. We could be looking at more hail for places like Andrews, Seminole, Snyder across the northeastern basin. That's why the storm predictions Center has issued the slight risk outlined in yellow for a lot of our northeast basin. Now, we've also got that marginal risk outlined in green, meaning we do have a chance for some of that weather to be moving through other parts of the basin and southeast New Mexico. Places like Hobbs and Tatum have a chance at that as well. Now, we've got that high humidity out there right now. Most of us are looking at some pretty humid conditions. Now, as those storms run through to the north and east, that's going to give them a good opportunity to ramp up in intensity. So here in West Texas, we don't get the worst of it, but we could still be dealing with damage from hail and damage from winds and a little bit of localized flooding too. Odessa Midland, we've got a good 40% chance to see some thunderstorms later on today with that high temperature at 89 degrees. Now tomorrow, 87 will be our high, and then we pick up to 91 again on Wednesday. Now, Wednesday, we get a chance for some isolated thunderstorms to develop just because of how hot everything is. That moisture is going to stay in place. That heat, that rising motion could give us some afternoon thunderstorms. Nothing really to worry about. I don't see any severe weather here by Wednesday. But Friday, Friday's the next day to watch out for. So tonight, we could be looking at some severe thunderstorms. Friday is a little bit too far out to tell how severe everything will be. The models are still disagreeable. But I've got my eyes on it. And you at home, keep your eyes here on Fox 24 News, and I'll keep you posted.
All right, sounds good. And people should definitely park their cars under cover parking tonight.
Just to be on the safe side.
Just to be on the safe side. It's crazy to see how many auto shops out here.
Oh, yeah.
They have an influx of people who need to get their windows repaired and dents fixed because of the severe weather that passed through last week.
Right. It should not be as severe as what we had last week, but it'll be close. We'll see some large hailstones. We'll see some damaging winds. And, of course, localized flooding.
All right. Well, thank you for those updates, Chase. But coming up here on Fox 24.